Hi friends, how are you all? So in the previous videos I explained what is DAC-IC and what are the various programs with help of DAC-IC, like sawtooth waveform generation, triangular waveform, similarly square waveform with help of DAC-IC, right? Now in this video I will give you a brief idea about what is ADC-IC. Okay, so what are the various pins of ADC, we'll see detailedly. See here, I will highlight it. Now let us see ADC. So it is call it as it is analog to digital converter. So ADC is a analog to digital converter. So it will convert analog data into equivalent digital data. Okay. So now let us see what are the various features of ADC. So generally we have many ADC ICs are there. So now in this presentation I will give you a brief idea about ADC 0803 IC number or 0804 or 0805. So all three ICs may having the same number of pins. So all these ICs are having same pins. So number of pins should be 20. Let us see few points. What are the main points related to any of the ADC? So first is it is a 8-bit successive approximation ADC. Nothing but if you give input is analog, output is digital. That too, how many bits are present? 8-bit. Okay, like that ADC takes analog and converting into 8-bit digital data. Then second point is conversion time is 100 microseconds. So for converting analog data into digital data, it takes up to 100 microseconds conversion time. Then accessing time is 135 nanoseconds. So what is this accessing time? We are giving analog input, right? So now that analog input is taking some time for accessing. That accessing time is 135 nanoseconds is the accessing time. Okay, then other is now the advantage of this ADC IC is it is having on chip clock generator, means the ADC itself having clock pins, whereas in 8086 even DAC also we don't have any clock. We are taking externally clock generator, okay, for operating 8086. Whereas here this ADC may have on-chip clock generator. So there are clock pins. See here in pin diagram we can see detailedly. So there is a clock in pin number 4. Similarly, clock out pin number 19. Okay, these two pins are connected to externally R and C elements. By choosing R and C, you know, we'll get the suitable clock frequency. Okay, so there is a relation also clock frequency with respect to R and C. We'll see. Okay, in the pin description time. Then other is it does not require any zero adjustment. So zero adjustment is not required here. Other is it operates on a single 5 volts power supply. So for operating ADC, we need 5 volts power supply. And one more advantage of ADC is it is having output meet TTL voltage level specifications. TTL means transient trigger level. Transient trigger level voltage level specifications are present here. Okay, so all these are the properties of ADC. So important one is conversion time is up to 100 microseconds. Okay, and it is internally having on-chip clock generator and it requires 5 volts power supply. And additionally, it is having TTL voltage level specifications are present here. And accessing time, analog data accessing time is 135 nanoseconds. And it will take analog data and converting it into 8-bit successive approximation, nothing but 8-bit digital data. Okay, like that some of the salient points of ADC. Now let us see pin diagram of ADC 0803 or 04 or 05 family if you take. So it is having total 20 pins, 10 in one side, 1 to 10 in one side, 11 to 20 in other side. Okay, now here let us see functioning of each pin detailedly. Now here there is a curved one. So left side it will indicate as a first pin. Okay, then right side it will indicate as the last pin, generally for a curve representation. Now let us see here CS bar. So CS bar is a chip selecting signal and this signal is essential for activating ADC. So in order to activate, in order to make analog data into digital, okay, CS bar must be activating. Who will activate? CS bar is activating with the help of external decoder or set of address lines from the processor. Okay, with the help of that we are activating CS bar. Now the other important point is write bar. CS bar and write bar must be activating. Okay, then only it is ready to perform analog to digital. So what is write bar signal? Write bar signal is nothing but whenever the signal is activating, then what happens? Now the ADC is ready to receiving analog data. So whenever write bar is activating, then only ADC IC is receiving analog data from any of the analog device. Okay, so write bar is activating, then only it is ready to receiving analog data from the any of the analog devices. Okay, for the write bar is essential. Then what is the other one? Read bar. So So whenever read bar is activating, then processor or any of the output device reads data from the ADC. So whenever read bar is activating, what happens? The processor will read the data, will read the which data? Digital data. So ADC will convert analog into digital, right? So after getting the digital, we get digital data present in DB0 to DB7. Through DB0 to DB7. So now if we activate read bar signal, processor receiving the digital data from DB0 to DB7. Okay, so CS bar is essential, then only ADC is ready to performing the required operation, and this is activated with help of external decoder or address line from the processor. Now read bar is activating, then only ADC will receiving the analog data. Okay, similarly read bar, whenever read bar is activating, then only processor reads the digital data from the ADC after completion of analog data into digital data. Then other is important one is INTR bar. This is very important. INTR bar. INTR bar is interrupt request bar signal. So see here, this INTR bar must be high during the time of analog to digital conversion. So during the time of analog to digital conversion, INTR bar signal must be high. Whenever conversion is completed, INTR bar signal must be low. Okay, this is very important point. And based on this pin, 8086 understood that whether the ADC operation is completed or not. So how we can decide? INTR bar signal must be high during the time of conversion, and INTR bar signal must be low when conversion is completed. Okay, so based on this information, processor understood that ADC work is completed or not. Okay, then other is two grounds are present: digital ground and analog ground. See pin number 8 and 10. We have analog ground, and this pin is connected to analog ground. This pin is connected to ground. Okay, because ADC one side is analog, other side is digital. For that, we have two grounds: analog ground and digital ground. Digital ground is also connected to ground. Okay, then we have two more: in plus and in minus. In plus and in minus. These two are the analog input pins, and these two pins are connected to op amp. Okay, I see the next line. I will show you. See here now. See in plus, in minus. In plus and in minus are connected to analog inputs. So analog input is connected to in plus pin. Okay. With help of op amp, negative is connected to ground, like that. So in plus is connected to analog input, and in minus is connected to ground. Okay, through op amp. Okay, through op amp. Next, let us see. That is in plus, in minus. These two are analog input pins, and one is connected to analog input signal, and other is connected to ground. Okay. Then other is let us say a reference by two. So why we use reference by two in some applications? For example, we have analog input of 10 volts, but we need 5 volts analog input. In that case, what happens? That reference by two pin is connected to 10 volts. Then it will give you 5 volts. So reference by two pin will be used to make analog input voltage into half of the value. For that case only, reference by two is used. Otherwise, may not required. Right? Then other is INTR bar is already explained, right? It is one during the time of conversion and zero when conversion is completed. Then let us see clock in and clock out. So how they are present? So clock in is pin number 4 and clock out is pin number 19. Let us see how they are connecting to external device and how much clock frequency it will generate. See here. So see the upper diagram. See here. Now we have clock in, clock in. This is clock in and this is clock out actually. Clock in, clock out. So how they are connecting? Clock in is connected to actually externally with elements R and C, R and C. So now the clock out is connected to one end of R, clock in is connected to other end of R, and C is connected to ground. So like that, this is actually internally the ADC 080804 having two pins, clock out and clock in. These two are connected to externally R and C via NOT gate. So here by choosing R and C values in such a way that we get the suitable clock frequency. See, there is a formula. Clock frequency is equal to 1 by 1.1 into RC. So if you choose R and C such that we get the required clock frequency. How much clock frequency we need? Accordingly, we choose R and C values here. Okay, so that's why clock in and clock out are connected to externally R and C elements. If you choose R and C values, clock frequency will vary. Like that, clock in and clock out are essential, and with help of these two pins, the ADC will generate on-chip clock signal. Okay. Then similarly, VCC is a power supply pin, and this pin requires 5 volts DC supply, right? Similarly, DB0 to DB7 are the digital output pins. digital output pins. So ADC will convert this analog information into digital, DB0 to DB7, and these 8 data lines are connected to lower byte of the processor. Okay, then these 8 data lines are connected lower data bus of the processor, or any of the port of 8255 also we can communicate. So ADC is communicated to either 8086 or communicated to 8086 with 8255 or without 8255. We can see in the coming video how 8086 is interfacing with the ADC, okay, in that with 8255 and without 8255. Okay, like that we have 20 pins, and functioning of each pin is like this. So here important one is INTR bar. So INTR bar is 1 during the time of conversion, and it is 0 when conversion is completed. Okay, that information is conveyed to processor. Accordingly, processor understood that the analog data is completely into digital data. Okay, so and read bar is activating only when the conversion is completing. Okay, write bar is activating in that time only the analog data is processed. And CS bar is essential in order to activate ADC chip. Two grounds are present, analog ground and digital ground. Okay, clock in and clock out, these two are the clock pins, and these two pins are connected to externally RNC elements through NOT gate for generating the required clock pulse. Okay. So in plus and in minus are the two analog input signals, and in plus is connected to one end of the op amp, and in minus is connected to ground actually. So if you want, you can connect directly in plus to reference analog voltage, and in minus is connected to ground. In some applications, we need reference voltage is half of the value only. In that case, reference by two pin is connected to that reference voltage. The reference voltage becomes half of the value. Okay, right. Like that, we can analyze the pin description of ADC and similarly few features of ADC controller. Okay, I hope you understand the ADC IC. Okay, and their pin description. Right. So in the coming video, I will give you a brief idea about how ADC is interfacing with 8086 with the help of 8255. Okay. If you really understand, please kindly share my video to your friends and subscribe my channel. Thank you.